What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're gonna be doing another boat project today, and I'm both excited and kind of annoyed that we even have to do this, but I'm gonna show you guys exactly what we're doing. So we're gonna go ahead and refinish the old boat project that my dad and I had worked on about 2 years ago. Today's project should be relatively inexpensive and relatively quick in terms of time and effort. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, first I'm gonna show you guys the materials we're gonna be using in today's project, and then I'm gonna show you guys our platform we're gonna be kind of adding on and building on. So check it out. That's very important. Quick dry time. We have our topside paint. So this is going to be the interior hull. A couple brushes. I have some more, but we have basically a mixing brush and an application type brush. Gloves of some sort while you're sanding, because, you know, got to protect the digits. Something to mix with. And let's go check out the boat. Before you guys go ahead and get all your sanding done and all your prep work, take something into consideration. PPE. So you want to wear full long sleeves, gloves, mask. Don't do as I did, because I got very itchy. Fortunately, I had a pool to jump into so I could kind of rinse and detox all that BS. Here's what we're working with. A lot of the kind of mildew that was on here, you can see, dried up. The sun did its thing. Since we had the cover on, just collected a lot of moisture. I'm gonna go ahead and sand all this. You can see it's flaking. Sand it, kind of a new, apply a bit more resin, new primer, new top coat, and this will all be as good as new. And if you're following me along, you can tell, you probably tell, this sea deck is new. I added that, I wanna say last summer. I believe I added that, cut that. And that's been great. Just obviously it's a bit more comfortable, just a bit safer, and just a kind of cooler, cleaner look overall. Yeah, as you can see, we've got our work cut out for us. But that being said, it is a cool little boat. I'll go and throw a couple pictures from some of the adventures I've gone on with it. And if you want to see the complete build that we did to get this thing back on the water, go ahead and check the top right. My dad and I did, I think, a pretty bang up job for our expertise and the tools we had at hand. So we got the boat clean by blowing it out, clean enough. Now we're gonna sand. These heavy traffic areas, you know, the bottom, you can see a lot of traction. That's where we really gotta focus, obviously. Since we're doing just kind of a top coat, we're recoating this. We don't have to sand this thing all the way down to the fiberglass. We just want to roughen up that surface to where we can just reapply, and it's actually gonna have something to adhere to. So this time around, when we do this, we're gonna do two top coats instead of one for longevity's sake. All right, so here's what we got done today. We did all the cleaning, sanding, and a bit of scrubbing. So the boat, as you guys saw, had a bit of algae in the back that we really had to scrub with Comet. And so that was a lot more labor intensive than I had anticipated. So it's taken a lot longer, but everything should be good. Prep wise, we should be ready to roll with our resin. Should be able to get all that taken care of, sand that, make sure everything's been kind of dusted away, and then we go ahead and paint. So hopefully tomorrow morning we'll be able to take care of all that, and by tomorrow afternoon hopefully this project should be done and you guys have a pretty reasonably easy to follow how-to for how to do this, basically. Yeah, see you guys tomorrow. All right, it is now the following morning. We are ready to apply our resin and catalyst, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna show you guys how we're gonna be doing that. Simple as following the instructions on the can. All right, now we're going to go ahead and pour this stuff, and it does have quite a smell to it, so I recommend doing this outside. Pour a little bit, and once you apply this catalyst, the hardener, you have about 8 to 12 minutes before it actually really hardens. So once you pour it, you better be ready to start brushing. How many drops was it? About 10 drops. So we're going to apply 10 drops of our hardener. We're going to mix it, and we're going to get going. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, that clearly did not come out as well as I would have hoped.
we gotta start mixing. And yes, this is gonna be a brush I'm gonna throw away, obviously, because it's gonna harden in these bristles. So I'm gonna go out and spread it, since I'm not gonna have time to grab the camera with me. And we're gonna get moving. So we went ahead and did the first batch. As you can see, this is emptied out. Once I get the second batch done and applied to the boat, I'll show you exactly where we did it. My hands are kind of messy and I'm trying to touch the camera as least as possible. But once I get this done, I'll clean my hands and I'll show you exactly where we did it and kind of the areas you really want to focus on if you have similar issues. So let's get to work. And this is just to kind of reinforce those problem areas. So you can just let that sit by itself, not gonna have any issues. Of course, once you apply that catalyst, it's gonna create an exothermic reaction and it's gonna get very hot. One, oh shit. 4, 5, 6. All right. So, and the clock begins, or the timer begins. As you can see, here is where I've applied the resin, just on some of those kind of stress areas on the boat. And once that dries in about 2 hours' time, go ahead and sand it. And we'll be ready to paint. All right, so now that we've let the resin dry, it's been about 2.5 hours or so, we're gonna go ahead and give that a light sanding so we can go up and move forward with the project and begin painting. Now, quick tip, if you end up not mixing enough catalyst in with that resin and it seems a bit runny, do another batch and just add additional catalyst so it hardens a lot quicker, and then just pour that over the resin you've already poured, and that should help harden it all and kind of create a nice cohesive bond. For consistency's sake, we're gonna go ahead and use the 120 grit sandpaper that we were using prior. I believe that's what I used the last time I did this project. So we're gonna go ahead and use this. And again, we're just giving it a real mild sand just to give the paint something to adhere to. So once I'm done sanding, I'll go ahead and show you guys me painting, because sanding is pretty boring and very tedious. So you've made it this far. That means you're ready to paint. Show you what you're working with. Topside by Rustoleum. This is the white. This is what we used prior. This is what we're gonna use again on that top coat. Stir stick and something to dispatch our paint with. So we just cut open an old little T-jet. All right, that being said, let's do some painting. And this is an entire can. Not too much, but it'll be enough to cover this boat. Not a big boat, guys. So whatever your project you're working on is, obviously you're gonna have to gauge how much you're gonna need. All right, here we go, we are done. This is the finished product. It is still drying though, as you can see, but man, that looks good. Nice and fresh, bright white. Yes, I see the rope, I didn't feel like untying it. It's just not meant to be an A+ project.